Hey, what's up, guys? So I'm gonna try something new here, and I'm actually gonna record me making a level for Treasurenauts. So without further ado, I'm gonna start my music, and I'm actually in the middle of making a level right now. Let's just kick our music in, a little bit of Green Day, Revolution Radio. That's right. So hopefully this is all recording right. Obviously if it's not, whatever, I'll figure it out next time. Maybe I can even stream some of this at some point in the future. Alright, so this is a level for Treasurenauts. So I've already started some of this, so I'm going to continue doing some of this. So this is the start point, where little player starts, and these boxes here all represent enemies or stuff like this. Like this blue number 2 is like spikes that come from the ground. This 8 is like a slimy enemy that bounces up and down and stuff like that. So I kind of slap them down so I can know what's up. This represents a double jump height. Double jump height, so I shove that around wherever. This is treasure chairs, or whatever. Anyway, so I'm just going to make a level. And this is my mini map here, which I I made this first, so each thing is just a little 8x8 pixel box. This is the first stage. Actually, let me show you real quick. I'll just step through this. The first stage of a level I made looks more like. So bear with me. I'm going to try to make a level. Or maybe I'll do this properly someday, but I'll just show you some more. Anyway, a level may start something like this. Obviously this is a different size, but bear with me. And this is like, great, I'm going to have the player start down here. I'm going to have the exit up here, etc. And I'm like, great, once I have everything in place, shove a treasure chest over here. Then I'll be like, great, start. Then I put these in there. Great, how do I want to play? Yes, so maybe, yeah, there's so many ways you can do this. You can level around to it. Like a nice shape like this. Stitch you everything. Like so. So anyway, so I kind of build up the levels like this, and you end up with something like this eventually. So I'll get rid of that for now. And I kind of imagine playing, you know, from the player here. Oh, with an enemy there, there's spikes here. Double jump, double jump. There's a plant there, there's pools there. I need to go around, blah, and the things. These represent secret walls, so you actually won't visually see there's a tunnel there until you actually kind of keep going into that wall, and then it gets revealed and everything. Anyway, so there you go. There's a really quick update on what that is about. And now let me try and finish these levels. So I might be quiet for a while, and I'm just going to work. So, yeah. Alright, rock and roll. Here, by the way, is promotion. It just is an art program. And what I like about it, I mean, it's what I like about it is I can pick things up on the grid and I can pick down the grid. No mess now, it's completely gridded, perfect, lovely, jubbly. I like things to line up, I guess, if you want, like, you want to potentially call it. I like it. clean and perfect, I guess. So, I get my kicks way back when we were making games for Super Nintendo and stuff like that, you had a freaking cool deluxe game, which is funnily enough, production was better yet. And this is very much based on that program.
Yeah.
seen that level, I did end up doing going back and changing some things, but get the idea. That's the key to being the boss. There's always try and make it so you can go back and change something. Because if you make that difficult or annoying or something you don't want to do, you might want to do it. And that's not good.
We're
drops everything. In this one, it's broken. I don't want to give everything away. It's something different. So, and that's what the ST stands for right here. So, anyway, that's why these are numbered. And then in every level, there are three special crystals. I place on the minimap where they exist. Like I say, spoiler central, by the way. So hopefully, we'll have forgotten all of this by the time the game comes out. But yeah. Okay. So that's the bottom. It's for our heart. Let me pick this guy up. Those decisions. I think because this is World 2, I'm going to be a little nasty there and kind of put it there, so it's not that nasty, honestly, because it's pretty easy to avoid it. Once you know how, you just jump up and see the enemy and just crouch immediately. I never. So far, all of the darts are residues that you can just crouch and they'll go over there. None of them are shooting you if you are. Yeah, that might change actually a lot. I don't understand. Just depending on you, projecting the light into the existing device. So you see here, like, so the double jump just happened to take me to a place where this floor. So Anyway, so I'm trying to, like, there's a lot of things that go through my mind when I'm placing things. You have to kind of consider everything. That's why my brain broke down there for a second. I'm trying to communicate way too many things at once. So these are spikes. These are spikes that come up from the ground. So if I place them like this, so then you're just going to have to wait when you get up there. So because I have this down here, which is similar in that regard, where you have to jump and immediately deal with it, it might be nice to make that a little less severe. So they kind of like jump, crouch, avoid, jump up, okay, now I'm out of harm's way. So it's not completely dangerous, you know? Okay, I've got an enemy here, so what I'm going to do is... I'm just going to put it roughly in space there for now. Create a shelf right there. I'll have some loot in there that little guy jumping up and down on. I'm like a child looking off the horizon. I'm like an ambulance standing on the sirens. Oh, I'm still alive. It'll just look like this. Like a soldier coming home for the first time. So I think it's nice to kind of communicate that it looks like this is a dead end, there's nothing there, why do I need to go there? But when you do, boom, you'll get to go into the end. Especially for a secret exit. There's a pretty cheap surprise exit, because that secret exit will take you to a level you can get to otherwise. The second world is definitely the challenge a little bit. So you jump up to the edge, you'll land here, you'll crouch to avoid the dart, you'll jump up, you'll just need to kind of land on this little edge here to, and possibly you can extend your crouch to see if then you'll land from here, crouch to the water. You can still see this, you can judge it.
Am I bleeding from the storm? To shine a light into the wreckage so far away.
barely come down. When you do jump in, you kind of go above it and then come back down and episode goes with it. So with that in mind, at what time should you the Britain jump, double jump, and you get higher and then land into it? Because actually the levels do have clues, which I'm not going to give away. There is a clue to the secret entrance, visual. See, in this situation you're on the ground run, even though this is a secret entrance too.
I feel like a cello.
ground just to help communicate, remind me that that is the case. If no one reads it, a day dawning comes without warning. So don't think twice. We live in troubled times. Oh. Oh, this is whatever is that point there. We live in troubled times. Okay, this is, alright, that's a secret up here, so it's supposed to look like this guy this way. Okay. So
what part of history we learn when it's repeated? Some things we'll never overcome if we don't
defend. Alright, so these are really cool to do. This is a nice method, and I like it, is, you know, I spend a lot of time thinking about this stage. I'm gonna get to this stage. But anyway, when I finally come to this, then I'm like, great, I've got all that brought into it. So then when I come to this, I can focus on just how all that's going to work now. In this particular level, as far as getting down to the particulars and how it works. Anyway, then when it comes to like this setup here, like do I put two plants there and, you know, those kind of holes, I spend a little bit of time thinking about it. Go, yeah, great, I think that'd be cool. And even if you're not 100% sure, but you're kind of more than 50% sure, you'd be like, yeah, great, just give it a shot. Because the nice thing is, the next stage, once this is done, is playing it. You know, and then you get to actually play it and go, alright, yeah, how does that feel good through the player's eyes now? So then, you know you'll have that final safety net and you're actually playing it before you're committing to it. You know, if I'm like, no, I'm going to get rid of this, it's as easy as that. What? I'll be actually placing it in there. Anyway, it's essentially as easy as that. So there we go. So that is a level, and you waffling about it and how I put it together. Very cool. I hope maybe this was interesting in some way. Thanks for sticking with this video, and I plan on doing more soon.